The 1977 Porsche 924 we've taken on now runs in top form.
This job is done.
And it's time to tackle one last but very obvious problem with the car.
So far, I've focused on the mechanics of this car. Now that they're all sorted, I need to make sure that she looks as good as she performs. And right now, the interior is really letting us down. Now, Mike's out on the road getting the parts I need, including a new dashboard. And that's exactly where I'm going to start. I'm going to get this old, cracked one out. These cracks are pretty common in old cars, and the major culprit is the sun. And this is the issue, the windscreen. As the heat and the UV comes in from the sun, it's amplified. It basically turns into a greenhouse. It breaks down the polymers within the plastic, and as it cools down overnight, it becomes brittle. And that's the issue. During the day, loads and loads of sun, it gets hot, and at night it gets cold. Day after day, week after week. It becomes a vicious cycle over many, many years. It's actually no wonder it ends up like this. It didn't really stand a chance, especially not here in California, where it's hot.
Aha! Appropriate timing. There is one replacement sensor console, and I've even got your replacement dashboard. That one really does look cracked up, that dashboard. It's seen better days, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's ruined.
Horrible.
It's almost out.
Like that.
There we go.
That is horrible. Let me get rid of that over there, and let me give you this. I found this cracking little replacement just round the corner.
So have you changed the colour?
Yeah, I like the brown. I think it looks much nicer. Plus, brown's in at the moment. It's a right retro colour. It's going to make it much easier to sell. Look at that.
That looks good.
It does. It looks really good. Right, so what's next?
Right, well, I'm going to get this car buttoned up, make it look fantastic, so you've got a chance of selling it. Well,
talking of which, I've got to come write the advert up.
Yeah, before you go, though, pass me that Phillips screwdriver just there.
No worries. There you go.
Thank you.
See you later.
Oh, Mike.
Yep.
Throw the old dash away.
Oh, God, anything else?
There's a good boy. It's starting to shape up really nicely. This brown dash looks brand new. But I've got to do the rest of the interior, which means one of us is going to have to do a night shift. And it ain't Mr. Brewer. The carpets have to come out, the seats have to come out, the rear seats, the door cards, the boot carpets.
The 924 from 1977 was a proper Porsche for the people. Its front engine, rear-wheel drive layout, made for the perfect handling balance in a remarkably drivable sports car. I was able to snag this motor cheap because it was let down by a fiddly oil leak, warm-up regulator, and a sloppy gearbox. Refreshing a tired interior was the final step to get this 924 ready for sale.
Look at that.
We paid $3,700 for the car. Main seals and gaskets were $360. Fixing the warm-up regulator cost just $20. We spent another $500 improving the shoddy gear change. Refreshing the interior was slightly expensive at $1,500. We gave $1,100 to fix the valance and polish the paint. Additional parts added $1,200 to the bottom line. With labour coming in at 46 man-hours, we're into this Porsche for a total of $8,380, or just a shade over £5,900. I think this Porsche's appeal will sell itself. But first, I want to enjoy it one more time and perhaps turn a few heads on the streets of downtown Los Angeles. Lovely, I'll see what you've done. Downtown LA, that cityscape with our little downtown cruiser. This car looks amazing. Look how well it's polished back.
Yeah, but you think it looks good on the outside?
Wow, no way, seriously. Oh, there was a few gripes coming from the workshop when I bought down that replacement dashboard and a complete interior, but come on.
I prefer the brown.
I know, the brown looks so much better. It's very retro, and come sale time, it makes the car so much more sellable. It's lovely.
All right, I've fixed the rough idle issue as well.
Oh, yes.
Listen.
That is beautiful. That's just how a 924 should sound. Well done, son.
This is now a gentleman's driver.
It certainly is. Outside, inside, no doubt there's no oil underneath now either.
Not a drop.
I love it. Love it.
Yeah, but wait. Wait till you feel her.
Oh, I can't wait.
This is a bit I've been looking forward to.
I don't encourage this at home, but I couldn't resist.
Porsche, LA, nighttime.
It's pretty good, isn't it?
Ticking boxes.
Yeah, we are ticking boxes. Right then, here we go. Look at this lovely stretch of road. Let's try this gearbox.
Open up, open up. Go on, go for the gears.
Oh yeah, baby, oh yeah. First of all, I have driven a lot of Porsche 924s, and that is the most precise gear shifter I've ever used in one of these cars. That, son, is a work of art. What did you do?
Well, after dropping the gearbox out the back, I made a short shifter. Feels nice and sharp, does it?
Oh, it's beautiful through the gears. Before, it felt like I had a wooden spoon in a bucket of porridge. It was just horrible. But now it's precise, it's engineered, it feels like a Winchester rifle. Look at that. Do you know, I said right at the very beginning of this, this was never about the profit. This was about the nostalgia of doing a car that started Wheeler Dealers 14 years ago. And I think we've paid homage to that car. And whoever buys this car, they're gonna get themselves a slice of Wheeler Dealer history. Click here to subscribe.